Hi, dear viewers. My name is Alexander. By agreement with my colleague Alexander Novikov, I have prepared brief technical overview for his YouTube channel. Today we will take a look on the equipment for thermal option lenses: pressure reducers, safety valves, oxygen hoses, and lens holders. Let's start with high flow rate pressure reducers. It should be understood that in order to use thermal option lenses, it is necessary to ensure not only an outlet pressure in the range of 10 to 20 bar, but also a flow rate of at least 130 cubic meters per hour. Here we have this pressure reducer made by Italian company Contessi with a check valve installed on it. The inlet pressure is until 220 bar. The outlet pressure could be set here even until 30 bar, but normally we are working in the range between 12 and 16 bar, which should be enough for us. This reducer provides an oxygen flow rate of 210 cubic meters per hour. It's important to note that this reducer has a piston, not a diaphragm, which provides less accuracy in adjusting of the outlet pressure, but much more reliability, which is what we need. The accuracy of the outlet pressure regulation is not so important for us as we work with thermal option lenses. The outlet on both the reducer and the check valve is 1/2 inch BSP, British standard of pipe, which is also important to ensure sufficient oxygen flow through the entire line from the pressure reducer until the lens holder and finally until the lens. Why I recommend to use pressure reducers with pistons, not with diaphragms? The point is, when we work with thermal option lenses, we have a much bigger oxygen flow rate to compare with working with normal cutting torches. And also we set the pressure, outlet pressure, a little bit higher. In this case, when you're working with thermal option lenses, your line is freezing. So all your equipment is freezing, and also pressure reducer is freezing. When it happens, the diaphragm, what is inside, loses its flexibility, and it could crack very simply. In this case, your pressure reducer will fail. This is the reason why I recommend to use a pressure reducer with piston, but not with a diaphragm. In order to connect the lens holder with a pressure reducer, you must use at least 1/2 inch fittings and an oxygen hose with inner diameter of at least 13 mm. It will also ensure a stable flow rate and prevents pressure drops throughout the entire line. These are the fittings used for these kind of hoses: nut, 1/2 inch, and hose tail. You can use special certified oxygen hose made by Italian company Contessi. This is self-extinguishing oxygen hose. It means it will not ignite when sparks or droplets of liquid metal will hit them. This side is going to be connected with the lens holder, like that. This side with protection spiral. And another side without protection spiral will be connected with the pressure reducer. There are also hoses with stainless steel braiding available. Some cutters like them more, however, they are more expensive, more difficult to repair, and if the braiding of the hose is slightly worn outside when used, then broken wire can unpleasantly prick your hands even if you have gloves on. You can simply order an oxygen certified hose from a company that sells hydraulic hoses. In this case, only brass or stainless steel hose tails can be used, but not steel connectors, as this is dangerous. When installing hose tails into the hose, do not use oil under any circumstances. This is very dangerous and it could cause to an explosion of the hose. You can moisten the hose tails with soap or water and then install into the hose, but not with oil. The same precautions should be taken when you are repairing the hoses. You can repair broken hose with the same hose connectors or hose tails and nuts. If you will put these two into the broken parts of the hose, then you can finally connect two pieces of hose with this straight connector, half inch connector. And the hose will be repaired like that. There are two most common types of lens holders. We will take a look on both. This one and this one. I will start with this 3/8 inch lens holder made by Italian company Contessi. It has a hand valve. The inlet is half inch BSP. It has a safety valve, body part made from brass, and locking nut or locking head made from stainless steel. What is inside of the body part of this lens holder? This pusher or piston, rubber ring. It is not a rubber seal, it works like a spring. Then you have here rubber seal and washer, very thin washer. And finally you have here collet or vise. All these parts are inside body part. What is inside of the locking nut or locking head of this holder? You have inside this steel bearing, spring ring, and washer. These are all the parts what are here inside of this locking nut. This lens holder has two types of locking heads. So one is with special protection tube. It prevents the parts inside the locking nut from the sparks and droplets of liquid metals what could flow inside when you work with the lenses. The lens is simply going through this protection pipe like that. Another locking nut is without this feature, just like that. Now I will disconnect all the parts, disassemble the lens holder, so you can see what will be inside of this one. I will untighten those side screws. Those screws are only in to hold the collet or vise inside the body part. So this is the collet. And this is rubber seal and the washer. And now we have this pusher. All the parts are here. I will now disconnect the body part from the safety valve so that you can see how it works. So, successfully disconnected. And this is the pusher of the safety valve. When you insert the lens inside the lens holder, it pushes against this pusher, or you can call it a piston as well. And this piston pushes against this part and opens the oxygen flow. You have here copper ring. So no need to use any tape or glue or something like that. In order to connect, I will tighten now with wrenches and so. Now let's fix it. We'll insert the pusher or piston, then rubber seal together with washer, after that collet or vise, and we'll tighten side screws. The side screws should be just on the surface of the body, not deeper, otherwise you can block this collet and it will malfunction. Now this part is assembled, and I will show you further what happens when you will disassemble the locking nut. Now I will show you how to disassemble the locking nut or locking head. I will use for that special pliers, a little bit modified. The jaws of the pliers are polished a little bit in order to have a possibility to insert in the gap between the locking nut body and the washer. I will insert these pliers into the holes in this spring ring. Then I will turn it in vertical position and disassemble. Now we have all the parts here. The locking nut or locking head is disassembled. Disassemble it always in vertical position. Do not try to disassemble it from this position or from this position, always like that. So as I told, you have here the bearing and spring ring and the washer. This is the washer, this is the bearing. And what happens when you will close this locking nut, this washer pushes against this vise or collet, and simultaneously it pushes against the rubber, and on this way you lock the lens inside the lens holder and prevent any oxygen leak. In order to assemble it, we will use it opposite, like that. And again, I will put it vertically and assemble it. Tally-ho! This locking nut. You can check how it's functioning. Just insert a couple of fingers into the washer, like that, and turn around. It should go very smoothly, like that. If it's not the case, we need to find the problem. We need to change, maybe we need to clean bearing, we need to clean all the parts, we need to change bearing probably. And in this case, to control it, if it's functioning or not, just always check it like that. Now I will assemble it on the lens holder and can show you how it's to use with the lens. You are inserting the lens until the end. In this case, the lens pushes to this piston, and the piston opens safety valve. Now it's locked. Now I will tell you about the problems, what could happen when you're using lens holder. Of course, it's quite dirty work, burning with lenses. It means some sparks or dust or even droplets of liquid metal could go inside all these parts of the lens holder. In this case, if you have some oxygen leak, you will never try to close it with some kind of wrench. So normally you close the lens inside the lens holder very simply, only with your hands. You even do not use your hand valve like a handle. So just put one hand here and one hand here and close it like that. And it will be closed very simply without any oxygen leak. If this is not the case, you need to find the problem. So it means you will disassemble, clean all the parts and use, for instance, compressed air in order to clean it. You can use this brush in order to clean inside the locking nut. You can use also this kind of brake cleaner in order to clean the parts. And finally, you will, after cleaning of all the parts, you can use compressed air in order to make it dry. And finally, you will assemble it again. What could happen, as I have told, here some droplets or dust or sparks could come on the street. Clean the street and check it. If you have some droplet of liquid metal, what is now seated up on the street, remove it, clean it. The same is valid for this part, for outside street on the body. So you can check it, clean it, and if everything is all right, then you can close the lens inside the lens holder very simply. What could happen? Some dust or even a droplet of liquid metal could come against the lamels of the collet. Check it always. Maybe you have something between the lamels, and in this case the collet could not be closed correctly. The same is valid for all the parts. What you could check: clean the rubber and check it. Maybe you have something inside, maybe not. If you see the rubber is a little bit dirty or very dirty, just take with you into the washroom, and then you can clean with you can wash your hands together with this rubber, and this is the best way to clean it. If all the parts are cleaned in good condition, then you will assemble it, all the parts, and your lens holder should work properly. What is also important, do not tighten those side screws very deeply. Maybe half of millimeter further than the surface of the body, but not really too deep. If you are doing so, you can block the vise or collet, and even in this case you will have some oxygen leak, because this collet will not work on the right way. I think it was all about the problems what you can solve by maintenance or by ordinary work with this lens holder. If the lens holder is not closed correctly, it is possible that you will have some oxygen leak here. It means you will not continue to work, and you need to find the problem. You need to close lens holder correctly. You need to clean the parts, as I have told before. But it means that if you have a possibility for oxygen leak, you may not use any oil or grease for lubrication here inside the locking head. The same is valid for this part of street, outside street here by the body. And also, do not use any oil or grease for the bearing. But what you may use instead of that, Teflon spray or silicone spray. This is the best way to do it. As I told before, this lens holder has a safety valve or safety backfire device. Device number is 5250, and it has four features. It works as a special device if no lens is inserted into the lens holder It shuts off the oxygen flow. Then it works as a thermal shutoff valve, a flame arrestor, and the check valve. If you don't want to have this kind of device which closes oxygen flow if no lens is inserted, you can use another device, and device number is 5249, and it has only three features: thermal shutoff valve, flame arrestor, and the check valve. It has no special device here for opening of the valve if no lens is inserted into the lens holder. If our company offers to one of our clients this kind of lens holders, we always offer this kind of spare parts kit. In this kit you have 10 rubbers, washer, pusher with rubber ring, a couple of bearings, a couple of spring rings, two vices or collets, pliers, and hexagon wrench. If something happens with your lens holder and one of the parts or maybe several parts need to be replaced, so you have all the stuff here and you can replace the parts and you can continue your work without any troubles. This is the best configuration of the lens holder. We have here very reliable hand valve and safety backfire device. This hand valve is quite expensive, and of course, if you don't want to use it, you can use instead of that this kind of hand valve. And if you don't want to have a feature no lenses inside, no oxygen flow, you can use another safety backfire device. The number is 5249. So, for instance, this is another option. What you can do, you can use it also without safety valve. It will be not so safe, but it will work. So, it will work as well, maybe not so safe, but it will work. But of course, in order to connect all the parts here and here, you need to use Loctite glue. Now we will take a look on the second type of lens holders. This lens holder is made by our company. It has stainless steel body part, after part is made from brass, and locking head is made from brass as well. The after part, as you can see here, looks almost the same like by this contact lens holder. Only we use here different safety backfire device, 5249 instead of 5250. Without this feature, no lenses inside the lens holder, no oxygen flow. I will take it apart now in order to show you what we have inside and why. So, this is the body. When we disassemble it, you can see here is some kind of piston or pusher. And actually, this after part of the body works like valve, shut-off valve, if no lens is inserted, no oxygen flow. When we insert the lens into the lens holder body, we open the oxygen flow. This is the reason why we don't need to use this special safety backfire device with the feature no lens is inside, no oxygen flow, because this feature is integrated here. We have in the body part rubber seal and conical ring. And in the locking head we have bearing. This is not steel bearing, this is plastic bearing, air column bearing, collet or vice, and locking ring or inside ring. So these are all the parts what we have inside the body. And now I will show you how is to disassemble locking head. Normally we have some special wrench for that, but now I'm using the same pliers as I used for contacting lens holder. Inside there is ring and plastic bearing. Now I will assemble once again. What happens when we're closing the locking head? This vise will push against this conical ring and will secure the lens inside the body part of the lens holder. You can very simply close it only with your hands. Not like that, but one hand is here, one hand is here, and closed. When we sell our lens holders to one of our clients, we always offer this set of spare parts. It has 10 rubbers, one threaded ring, a couple of collets or vices, a couple of air talon bearings, and one or two conical rings. Normally conical ring cannot be broken, but you can lose it sometimes if you disassemble the lens holder and if you will turn it unfortunately like that, and conical ring falls down and you can lose it very simply, especially when you're working in the dirty environment like on the scrap yard or something like that. If you don't want to use this kind of expensive hand valve, it's possible to use this kind of hand valve made from brass or from stainless steel. From stainless steel should be a little bit better, because it's more reliable. And in this case you can use also safety backfire device from Contesi 5249, or even you can use it without any safety backfire device like that. Only with hand valve. By this lens holders, you have all the parts here glued together with Loctite. Here, after part of the body, with this body part made from stainless, here between Loctite has been used, and here by the hand valve, by the thread, and here by the after part, by this connector. This Loctite. Now I will tell you something about maintenance. On the same way as with maintenance for Contesi lens holder, you can do almost everything here. You can clean the locking nut inside with brush. If you have some metal droplets seized up inside on the thread, you can use even this brush, or if it's not going with the brush, in order to remove them, you can use this thread file, special tool. The same is valid for outside thread here on the body part. You can wash the rubber seal when you are going to wash your hands. It's very nice to wash always with soap, and then clean with compressed air and install it back. And if all your parts are clean and everything is alright, then you will very secure close the lens in the lens holder. When the bearing is not in good condition and you have a lot of small parts and dust seated up on this surface where the flange of the collet is coming, just replace the bearing. This is the best way to do it. And if everything well maintained, then you can close the lens inside the lens holder very simply only with your hands. What is important, don't use any grease or oil. In order to lubricate the inside thread or outside thread, you can use Teflon spray or silicone spray, but no oil or grease. This Ertalon bearing doesn't need any lubrication. It works without any oil, grease, or even without Teflon or silicone spray. Works like that. It is possible to use both types of the lens holders, this one or this one, with 3/8 of an inch lenses or with lenses with outside diameter of 16 millimeters. Now we will take a look at first on the lens 3/8 of an inch. This lens is made from the pipe with an outside diameter of 17.2 mm, wall thickness of the pipe is 2.3 mm, inner diameter of the pipe is 12.6 mm, and this lens is filled with 20 wires with outside diameter of 2.2 mm. The lens is 3 meters long and it has the weight of 4.35 up to 4.5 kilograms. Now we will take a look on the lens made from the tube 16 millimeters. Outside diameter of this tube is 16 millimeters. Wall thickness is 1.5 millimeter. Inside diameter 13 millimeters, and this lens is filled with 20 or 21, 22 wires with outside diameter 2.2 millimeters. This lens is 3 meters long and has the weight of 3.5 kilograms. When we will compare those two lenses, then it's even really difficult to see the difference in inner diameter. Actually, the lens 16 millimeter has a little bit bigger inside diameter than the lens 3/8 of an inch. In this case, capacity of 16 millimeter lens is also a little bit higher, about 3% or something like that. So, and if you don't need to connect the lenses with each other, if you don't need to make a thread on the lens or use special threaded sockets, then you can use for ordinary work like demolition work or work on the scrapyard the lenses with outside diameter of 16 millimeters. In order to use this lens holder for 16 millimeter lenses, the only part what you need to change is the rubber seal. Instead of this rubber seal for 3/8 of inch lenses, you can use this rubber seal for 16 millimeter lenses. In order to use this lens holder for 16 millimeter lenses, you need to change this rubber seal. Instead of the rubber seal for 3/8 of inch lenses, you can use rubber seal for 16 millimeter lenses. And you need to change the vise or collet. This vise is for 3/8 of inch lenses, and this vise is for 16mm lenses. If you will change those parts, you will close the lens 16mm with both types of the lens holders very fast and without any trouble. Now I will tell you about some small problem which could happen when you are working with thermal option lens. If you work with the lens, the temperature of the lens holder drops, and even you have closed your locking nut correctly, it could happen that the lens will be pushed away a little bit from the lens holder like that. In this case, the safety valve will close the oxygen flow. The same could happen with another type of the lens holder, with this one. The lens is pushed away a little bit from the lens holder, and the valve located in the after part of the body will close the oxygen flow. And your lens is not working anymore, it's not burning, because the oxygen flow is blocked. How is to solve it? You will close the oxygen flow, the hand valve, open a little bit the locking nut, push the lens into the lens holder, close the locking nut again, ignite the lens, open the oxygen flow, and you will continue to work without any problem. Our company produces different lenses from 6.35 mm outside diameter up to 3/4 inch BSP. We offer also different equipment for thermal option lenses like pressure reducers, oxygen hoses, our own lens holders, or contacting lens holders, and all the needed spare parts for both types of lens holders. You can find all the needed information about our company on our internet site. So, I think you received from me today quite a lot of information. I hope everything was clear, and I was happy to be with you today. Subscribe, like, let your comment, and it was really big pleasure for me to make this technical overview for you. Thank you and bye-bye.